Hello friends, once again I am happy in welcoming you all to this video series on saluting women in history. As we all know that patriotism and nationalism have no gender, caste, color, or religion. It is just a will to assert our identity and love our country, which is as much ours as it is of every fellow citizen who dare to question injustice. So when we go by this factual knowledge, the contribution of women in India's independent movement was in no way less than men. But most of the books on Indian history did not include many women freedom fighters who were considered to be the harbingers of change and embodiment of women power. But it looks quite unfortunate that many names of these brave hearts have been lost, and the list was also quite, especially on the contribution of Muslim women freedom fighters. Naturally, it is a pity that their role in the struggle for freedom has not been adequately presented in the national history. What is even more surprising is the fact that the role and contribution of Muslim women in the War of Independence and the subsequent movements have been totally ignored by the historians, even though they fought gallantly and suffered heavily. But when we cherish our achievements and enjoy the fruits of freedom today, after these long times of 75 years, we should never forget any individual, either a man or a woman, who toiled hard and sacrificed much for the day of independent India. Majaz, a revolutionary poet, gave a call in mid-20th century to young women in his poem to lift their veil for the cause of nation. But before that itself, the Muslim women had begun to make a banner of their veils, and they were already playing their part in India's freedom movement in the middle of 19th century itself. For instance, in the revolt of 1857, Ashgari Begum challenged the British rule in the present-day Uttar Pradesh. However, she was captured by the British in 1858 and burnt alive when defeated. Similarly, Habibi and Rahimi fought many battles against the British in Muzaffarnagar and obstructed the advance of English forces, but they were captured and hanged along with 11 other female warriors. According to Imtiaz Ahmed, the CEO of Ilium Academy, it is estimated that about, you cannot imagine, that 225 Muslim women of India gave their lives in the 1857 revolt against the British. The voices of Muslim women became louder in the first decade of the 20th century, and on the occasion of this 75th Independence Day, let us remember these Muslim women who proved their strength, enthusiasm, and determinism in the fight for freedom. First of all, we shall look into the contributions of the remarkable Muslim women who fought for Indian independence. In this, the first woman who comes in the list is Begum Hazrat Mehr. She was the wife of Wajid Ali Shah, the Nawab of Oudh, who was banished to Bengal by the British. Post her husband's banishment, Begum took charge of Oudh as a regent and played a prominent role in the revolt of 1857. Like Rani Lakshmibai, she challenged the British rule and especially opposed their mechanism of destroying the religious places. She is also known for leading a rebel force to capture Lucknow, where she ruled for 10 months and confined the British rulers in the Lucknow residency. This event is recorded in the history as Siege of Lucknow. However, later the British rulers defeated the rebel force and Begum went into political asylum in Nepal and died in Kathmandu on April 7, 1879. She is said to have given the longest resistance to the British rule. Abadi Banu Begum, popularly known as Bi'amma, she set an exemplary precedent for all women in general and Muslim women in particular, as She shattered the stereotypes associated with the traditional Orthodox Muslim woman. She is a lesser known freedom fighter who left no stone unturned as she took part in the nation's freedom struggle, contributed to ensure Hindu-Muslim unity, and participated in the Khilafat movement. She was also the mother of the great freedom fighters Muhammad Ali Jauhar and Shaukat Ali, popularly known as Ali brothers. Bi Amma was a courageous and intelligent woman. Even though widowed at a young age, she shouldered the responsibility of raising her children with utmost sincerity and dignity. On Mahatma Gandhi's advice, Bi Amma played a vital role in encouraging women to take part in the freedom struggle. Moreover, she also played a pivotal role in Swadeshi movements. She also collected funds and organized meetings to teach women the importance of discarding British goods and using the Swadeshi products. Besides all these things, she was a progressive thinker who gave importance to modern English education in a time where English education was compared to infidelity. She was one of the protagonists of Hindu-Muslim unity during the freedom struggle and campaigned hard for communal harmony, preaching that communal harmony is imperative to win freedom. She called Hindus and Muslims the two eyes of India and worked tirelessly for amity between the two communities. Bibi Amatus Salam. She was a proactive freedom fighter and close as the adopted daughter to Mahatma Gandhi. Born in Punjab and following the footprints of her elder brother Muhammad Abdul Rashid Khan, she is committed to Gandhian method of freedom struggle and a firm believer in non-violence, and served the people of the country by joining in the Khadi movement. Later, she joined Gandhi's Shevagram Ashram in 1931 and followed its principles very efficiently. Apart from achieving independence, maintenance of communal harmony, as well as welfare of Harijans and women being her life ambitions, she accompanied Gandhiji to the riot-torn Naukhali and held 20 days Satyagraha to normalize the situation in those areas. Thus, she spent all her life to Gandhian ideology and service of the nation and breathed her last on October 29, 1985 to be immortal in the history of national movement. Another remarkable Muslim woman was Hajra Begum. Hailing from Uttar Pradesh, she came to know about the sacrifices of the freedom fighters who were fighting against the British from her father, who was a police officer. After the failure of her marriage, she went to London to pursue her higher education, where she got acquainted with the anti-British forces. This led her to decide to fight against the British imperialist forces in order to liberate the nation. And she had to face the anger of the British government as she was criticizing their acts in several international fora. She returned to India and joined as a lecturer in the Karamat Hussain Women's College at Lucknow in 1935. She also worked along with the famous poet Sajjad Zahir in the formation of All India Progressive Writers Association. She got married to a nationalist leader, Dr. Zainul Abidin Ahmed, in 1935, and in the same year, both of them took the membership in the Indian National Congress. Since the police were after them for their anti-British activities, they resigned their jobs and dedicated themselves to the Indian National Movement. She spoke on different subjects in the workshop as a lecturer. Hajra Begum was against the gender bias since her younger age. She fought against all types of inequalities very successfully, and she became very popular as Hajra Apa in the circles of toiling people and women. The Soviet Union honored her with Supreme Soviet Jubilee Award in 1960 in recognition of her work for the downtrodden people on the eve of the birth centenary of Lenin. Hajra Begum, who spent her entire life in the service of the country, breathed her last on 20th January 2003. It is important to highlight here that Pingali Vengaya has always been regarded as a man who came up with the design of our Indian flag. But contrary to the popular belief, the idea for the flag developed through the years with many names contributing to it. Pingali, in fact, was a designer of the Swaraj flag of the Indian National Congress. But Suraiya Tyabji was the one who came up the final idea for the Indian flag, but was never credited for it. It's high time we recognize her contribution and give her the credit that she deserves. The other notable Muslim women were: when Mahatma Gandhi launched the civil disobedience movement, Lady Sakinatul Fatima discarded the parda, bought a charka for daily use and wore only khadi. Married to a magistrate, knighted by the British, Sakinatul Fatima became part of the movement which would go on to dismantle the colonial British rule. Jahanara Shahnawaz, who was elected first to Punjab Legislative Assembly and then to the Central Constituent Assembly of India, is another important Muslim women freedom fighter. The three Faizi sisters, namely Atiya, Zohra and Nazli of Bombay, who has got the passion for freedom, expressed their struggle for women's education. Sharifa Hamid Ali, also from the Tyabji clan, drew up a model called Nikhanama in the 1930s and was a nationalist to the core. Shaista Ikramullah from Bengal was elected in 1946 to the Constituent Assembly, and her fervor for independence found in her writings. Then there were women who we know as writers but were passionate freedom fighters, like Ismat Chughtai, Rashid Jahan and many others. The history of the national movement would be incomplete without mentioning the services of Akbari Begum, Amina Qureshi, Amina Tyabji, Amjadi Begum, Anis Begum, Ashgari Begum, Asmatara Begum, Aisha Ahmed, Azizan, Begum Kurshid Khwaja, Begum Nishatunisa Mohani, Begum Rana Liaqat Ali Khan, Begum Shakina Lukmani, Begum Sultana Hayat Ansari, Begum Zinat Mahal, Dr. Darkashan Anjum, Fatima Ismail, Fatima Qureshi, Fatima Tayyab Ali, Hamida Tyabji, Hajra Bibi Ismail, Jamalunisa Baji, Kaniz Sajida Begum, Khatija Begum and Kurshid Sahiba of Frontier, Kulsim Siani, Masuma Begum, Meher Taj, Munira Begum, Nishatunisa Begum, Kulsum Siani, Raiban Tyabji, Rehana Tyabji, Dr. Rashid Jahan, Razia Khatun, Sadat Banu Kichlu, Shafia Sad Khan, Shakina Banu Begum, Safatunisa Bibi, Sharifa Hamid Ali, Shukra Khatun, Sultana Hayat Ansari, Sayyida Fakhr Krul Hazia Hassan, Zahida Khatun Sherwani, Jora Ansari, Zubaida Begum Dawoodi and Zulekha Begum. All these women participated in all the political movements from partition of Bengal to the partition of India with Congress banners in their hands. They were imprisoned, fined, lathi charged and suffered for a cause. Their life story itself is a part of the national movement which cannot be denied at all. The collected works of Mahatma Gandhi speak of their magnificent contribution to India's struggle for freedom. Several monographs in which Santima Rai's freedom movement and Indian Muslims, or P.N. Chopra's role of Indian Muslims in the struggle for freedom, Kanta Chaubey's Muslims and freedom movement in India, and a few regional studies like Muzaffar Imam's role of Muslims in the national movement and Hassan Imam's Indian national movement regarding the role of Muslims have been published. But the subject is very wide and needs a comprehensive study. But whatever may be all the reasons, all these women were to be given a big salute in history. Thank you for watching, and I will see you all in the next video with another important topic.
Please like, share, and subscribe to this channel.